In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use CiteWrite in combination with automatically generated citations, such as from Google Scholar, the QUT library, or any other source, to put together your references, make sure they're correct, and save yourself a bit of typing. I have a blank document here where I'll write my reference list, and I have QUT CiteWrite open as well. The source I'm going to cite is this one on the role of carbon offsets in achieving carbon neutrality. To create a reference for this article, the first thing I need to do is go to CiteWrite and find the correct template. So my source is a journal article, and it's an electronic article. Then I have a few templates I can choose from depending on whether the article has a DOI, if it doesn't have a DOI, or if it has an article number or an e-locator. So I'm going to look at my article to see if it has a DOI. Now, if I look down in small type at the bottom of the page, I can see a DOI here. This article also has a page range, which it usually wouldn't if it had an article number. There's also not an article number on the article, so I know that I will be using this template. So what I'm going to do is copy the template into my document. So the first thing I want to check is just that all of the formatting has copied across correctly. So I want to make sure that everything that was in italics in the CiteWrite template is showing up in italics in my Word document, which it is. It's all copied across correctly. Now I have a couple of options. I can just look at my article to find the information and type that information in over the top of my template. So for example, I could just type the year in over the top of where year appears in the template. Instead of that, I'm going to use an automatically generated citation. So to get a generated citation, I'm going to copy the title of my article. And I can look for that article either in the QUT library or in Google Scholar. If I was to use the citation from QUT library, I select the article, come down here to citation, and I have a few different referencing styles available, but I could just copy this automatically generated citation and follow the method that I'm going to show you. For this video, I'm going to use the Google Scholar version. This is my article here in Scholar. I'm going to click on Cite. Again, I have a variety of styles offered. I'm going to copy the APA style reference and paste that into my document. Now, with these two references side by side, I want to compare and make sure that all of the elements that are in the CiteWrite template are also showing up in my reference and that they're all correctly formatted. I'm also going to pull up my original article to make sure that the information that appears in the generated citation is complete and correct. So comparing the template with the generated citation, I can see that the author's name is here along with their initials. That's the correct author's name from the article here. The year it's giving me is 2014, and I can see both here and in the publication information at the bottom that 2014 is correct. The title of the article is correct and formatted correctly, and so is the title of the journal. But I can see that my template says I need a volume, an issue, page numbers, and a DOI, and none of that is showing up in the reference that I copied from Google Scholar. So I'm going to copy this information, change this full stop to a comma to match the punctuation that appears in the template here, and paste in the missing elements. So now I have placeholders for all of the information I'm missing. I need to find this information. So I need a volume and I need an issue number. Going back to the article, I can see that there's a volume number here and also an issue number. So I'm going to type that information over the top of my template. My volume number is 26. My issue number is 8. And again, I want to make sure that my formatting stays the same, so the volume number is still in italics and I haven't changed any of my punctuation. So the issue number is still in brackets. Next, I need the page range. This is actually given to me here on the front page of the article. If that information isn't there on your article, all you need to do is find the page number of the very first and the very last page. So my first page number I can see is 1179. And my last page number is 1199. So the last thing I need now is the DOI, and I need the DOI formatted like a link, as it is in the template. If I return to the front page of my article and my DOI, I can see here that it's formatted a little bit differently. So here the DOI starts with 10 dot. So what I will do is copy this DOI, paste it into my template, and then I'm going to add the link formatting to make this a link. So now my reference has all of the elements that are needed. There's one more step to do before we're finished. I can see in CiteWright that the reference list entries all have this indent where the first line is against the margin and then the following lines are pushed in. The way that I get that formatting in Microsoft Word is I select my reference, right click and select paragraph. Then I want the indentation section and I want to select hanging indent. I click OK and now my reference is completely formatted.
If you need more help using CiteWright or with any other aspects of referencing, contact QUT Library at www.library.qut.edu.au/help.